Hello YouTubers. Okay, so this is a little video clip on this NDL1205SC DC to DC voltage converter. This again is a handy package or recommendation by Electrodas. I'll add the link to his video channel. He has some very interesting videos. He suggested this for my solar powered Kindle. Basically, this package can accept an input of anything. I think it's between 9 to 18 volts, and it gives out 5 volts, and then obviously it will step up the current depending on how much voltage you're putting in. So I thought I'd just quickly show that. It's a very nice package. It has actually got a pin out at the bottom here. There's quite a few pins. It does a bit more than just DC to DC converter. It's got a built-in capacitor if you need it. One of these pins you can use to actually switch off the package or let it switch on. If it's disconnected, then it obviously remains on. And the one thing I'll make people aware of, I'll just quickly point you to the actual data. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to see that, but that is the data sheet for it, and you'll see there's a detail of the pins. So basically 1 is ground, 2 is your voltage in, 3 is control, 5 isn't used, it's internal, 6 is your positive voltage out, 7 is your negative voltage out, and 8, that's the capacitor, built-in capacitor. Now, the thing to be wary of, which caught me, was when I was connecting these up, I just read that, and I said, pin 6 is V out. And I just counted the pins on the IC, but there's one pin missing. So basically it goes 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you have to ensure you look at the data sheet on this when you wire it up, and that you look at the actual counts on the data sheet, because if you just go by the side piece and count the pins, you'll go wrong like I did. But anyway, it wasn't a train smash, because the one I soldered needed to be soldered anyway. Okay, so what we've got set up here again, as before, I've got my bench power supply, the multimeter over here is showing the voltage that it's set at, just below 12 volts. This is the current that it's putting out, 187 milliamp. I've got the normal incandescent globe. It's a 12 volt globe, but it's running at a low voltage of 5 volts. So this is the 5 volt out from the DC to DC converter. And then this is the milliamps at 346. And as you can see, it has been stepped up from what's going in. What I'm going to do is I will step up the voltage. As you see, as I step it up, the input current is dropping. Obviously the load is staying the same, and if you know the power equation, obviously the power you put in is the power you get out. There's obviously this package is, I think, 73% efficient, so there is some loss, but as you can see, as you step up the voltage, and we'll go all the way up to, fluke just timed out, there we go, as we go up to 18, you can actually go to 20, but that's absolute maximum. So we'll go just above 18, and as you can see, we're for 126 milliamp, we're getting the 346 out. Now those figures look fairly healthy for me and my solar powered Kindle. I say that the 126 could be a bit of a challenge, and the 18 volts. But I've come across there's another challenge, which I'm just going to quickly demonstrate. I will take this back down to, I'll take it down. The operating voltage of my panel will be around 15 volts. Of course, in reality, there could be some drops. So, but anyway, theoretical. Okay, so for one, obviously the current in might be a challenge, but it's the starting current. Now what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to on my bench power supply, I'm going to limit the current, which is in essence going to switch the package off. Now I'm going to slowly bring the current up. And now just what I want you to do is, obviously it's not going to have a proper output at the moment because it's not operational, it hasn't got enough current, but watch the current requirement on the input side before it gets the output going again up to 5 volts. So as I step up, you'll note we still haven't got the correct output voltage down here. So it's going up to 200, 250, 270, 280, 300. It still hasn't really kicked in. It's not doing the proper DC to DC conversion. 400, 440, 450, 60, 500, 550, 560, bang. And suddenly it kicks in and it's working. That was up to 560 milliamp. So I'm not quite sure whether that's how the package operates or whether there's a problem. But if that is the case, then I'm certainly going to have a problem with the solar powered Kindle with this package, even though it's a nice, neat, small one, because I'm certainly not going to be able to raise up to that current. I say not, but the one way of possibly doing it is putting some supercapacitors in front of the, basically on the input side of the DC to DC converter. They'd have to be able to handle the voltage, so I'd have to have probably several strung together in series. Let them build up a charge, and then they would be able to release a big punch of current to get this going. But that kind of wasn't what I was hoping to do. Anyway, it's another challenge. I'm not sure how I'm going to overcome it. I'm going to actually physically connect this to the solar panel on the Kindle and just see what happens. But anyway, I thought it'd be interesting to introduce you to this package. It's very neat, and some people might have some very useful applications for it. Okay, thanks again for watching, and if you do enjoy these videos, do subscribe.